This new feature is great because it allows simulation users to get that level of detail and accuracy that's required to make a system reflect reality.
Let's take a look at the new overtime feature in SIMUL8 2016. This feature can be used to extend the working hours of the day to help ensure that all vital work in the simulation has been processed. We'll start with this example simulation. First off, double-click on the on-screen clock to see the clock properties. So, as you can see, we're running our simulation for 8 hours a day, starting at 9 a.m. There's now a new option here allowing you to extend the day with overtime. If I check this box, there is an option to add a maximum amount of time that the day should be extended by. In this example, we are running in minutes and want to extend the day by 2 hours or 120 minutes. But first, let's run the simulation to see what happens when overtime is not enabled. The start point will generate items based on distribution. Those items will then wait in queues until processed by the activities. In this example, the working day ends at exactly 5 p.m. At this point, the simulation will jump to the start time of the next day, including work in the system that hasn't been processed the day before. So let's go ahead and add in some overtime to this example. If we go back into the clock properties, we can go ahead and check the box to extend with overtime and use a period of 120 minutes or 2 hours. Now, the first thing you might notice is the clock resets to midnight and is now red, which indicates that overtime is enabled in the simulation. If I just step through the simulation, you'll see that the first event is the clock jumping to 9 a.m, the start of the working day. Let's run the simulation again to see what happens when overtime is enabled. Again, items go through as intended, but at 5 p.m, overtime will extend the day. It will change to overtime for the 2 hours we set, and the clock will turn red. When the simulation is in the overtime period, any start points cease to create arrivals. However, all objects continue to process work items for the duration of the overtime period. Only the work items currently in the system are being processed in the activities. Of course, this doesn't mean that it will clear the entire system. That depends on the length of overtime. However, what it does allow your system to do is catch up, so it can try to process as many items within an extended time frame. If we run the simulation to the end, I can show you the new overtime results, which are available to analyze. Let's go into this activity and select its results. You will notice there is a new option at the bottom to choose the time that we want to look at. Normal time represents the regular working day, in this case 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. We can choose to focus on the overtime results, or we can choose to look at the results for both periods combined. These results are available on the activities, on the queues, or even resources. The overtime feature allows additional functionality in the activity routing in properties. If I select this activity, go to the routing in option, and choose the options tab, there are now two new options here. This will allow you to control what the activity routes in during overtime, if anything at all. The first option is during overtime. This allows you to set which activity will not select any work item when the overtime period has occurred. The second option is blocked during normal overtime. This allows you to set an activity to process items during an overtime period only. This great feature adds lots of flexibility to simulations. For example, if you're working in a medical clinic, you may want to ensure that the system is seeing as many patients as it can, even if the day has ended. Or another example is if you are in manufacturing and you want to look at how much overtime you'll need in order to get your desired throughput.